When you're singing in the cathedral, you obviously, you can move a lot of people. You make a difference to their lives.
I've seen somebody crying before.
Does it make any difference to you?
Not really, no. No, I just go about it as I usually do. No, well, oh dear. But I think when people are overcome by this sort of thing, I don't really take any, well, I do take some notice, but not as much as, say, somebody very, very, that had a real soft heart and something like that, but no, I don't pay much notice to them, not really.
Do you get fed up of singing ever?
No, never, never.
Do you always feel like singing?
Yes, I love singing.
You spend a lot of your time singing hymns.
Yes, well, they're a bit boring sometimes.
And church music?
Church music, Elizabethan times, we sing like Talis and Bird. It's horrible, you know, but I'll still enjoy singing the notes, no matter what. Maybe the words, you know, like Merry Maids and things like that.
What about the words, what about the religious words? Do they mean anything?
Yes, I think they mean a lot. A lot to everyone, really.
When your voice breaks and you leave here, what will you do?
I don't know. I couldn't say, you know, if I don't get it back. Because sometimes you can't get your voice back when it's broken. Yeah. I wouldn't know what to do, you know.
But if you do get it back, what will you do?
Well, I think I'll carry on singing. I don't know what type of singing I'll do because you can't really tell. But I like country and western.
If there's an apparent contradiction in the lives of Paul's children today between the medieval notion of existing in order to serenade the creator and yet being a part of the modern world, they don't seem to feel it. And at this time of year, as we are drawn into their world, there can be few who are not grateful that they're still there. Christmas at the choir school means not only the splendour of carols in the cathedral, but also a tradition that the youngest boys get together each Christmas to plan their own entertainment for the household staff.
Up in a deeply religious home, but when, as a child, I attended Sunday school, and I found that what spoke to me most was the music that we sang and the music that was played. And I remember as a child being taken to the local parish church and hearing the crucifixion and you know, works of that sort, and this meant a great deal more to me than the person who was actually speaking. I mean, as a child, I suppose the sound of music is more pleasurable to listen to than a single voice droning on from the pulpit, dare I say it. But, you know, I wanted to be part of that and give people the sort of experience I was getting. And it has to be church music. I can't see myself, although I do, I have done pop music, I've played the cinema organ, I've played in dance bands and all the rest of it, played the piano, and I accompany occasionally for song recitals and things. It's always the religious music where I get my experiences from, certainly. And it does strange things to your own inside when you do that sort of music. Very strange things indeed.
Does it still do it to your inside?
Yes, even after 20 years, it still does it.
Wedding nationwide begins at 6:15.